In this video, we will go over the area of segment. So when theta is in radians, this is the formula right here. So area of segment would equal this piece right here. However, if theta is in degrees, like 90 degrees, 120 degrees, etc., then the formula is this. And we will solve an example, so don't worry. So if you want, I would pause the video here and copy these two equations. So in understanding what is the area of the segment, we need to go over a few things. So the area of a sector is the whole area right here, this piece right here. Now if I draw a line from here all the way to this point is a simple triangle. And what we want to find is the area of a segment. So this piece right here, this piece right here, this is the area of a segment. And so it's going to be the area of the sector, this whole piece right here, minus the area of the triangle, this piece right here, would give us this piece right here. This is the area of the segment, and in this video we will go over the area of a segment, so this piece right here. So again, this is the two formulas. We have two formulas, one for radians, if you have like pi 4, pi 6, etc., and one for degrees, like 90, 120, 360 degrees. So in this particular problem, we have the radius of 6, we have 90 degrees, and we want to know what is the area of the segment right here. So we want to know what is the area of this region. And because in this problem I have 90 degrees, I also know that it's equal to pi over 2. Pi over 2 is equivalent to 90 degrees, so I can solve it both ways. So first we will solve in terms of radians. So theta will be pi over 2 divided by 2 times r. We said r is 6, so times 6 squared minus sine parentheses pi over 2, close parentheses, divided by 2, times r, which is 6, 6 squared. So this is what we have right here. Use a calculator, you would get 9 pi minus 18 units squared. Now we'll do it in terms of degrees. So we go 90 degrees, so 90 times pi divided by 360 times r squared, which is 6 squared, minus sine 90 divided by 2 times 6 squared. So this is what we did right here. Use a calculator, you would get 9 pi minus 18. Now it's very important, when you use a calculator, for radians, you need to go in radians mode, and for degree, you need to go in degree mode. If you do that, then you will get the correct answer. So I just simply copied this, put it here, went with radians, and I get 9 pi minus 18. I simply went with this, copied it, went with degrees, use a calculator, you get 9 pi minus 18. And that's all you need to do for this problem.